Oh, hey. I bet you didn't know I could crochet. Just like you didn't know how valuable the NetworkChuck Academy is. We've got practice exams, videos that won't put you to sleep, and an amazing community that'll help you get further in IT. It's pretty awesome. Now back to crocheting and back to the video. You know, sometimes superheroes can be kind of annoying, right? Windows Defender, you may not want him on all the time. That was a weird opener. Are superheroes, are they annoying? I don't know. But let's talk about virus and threat protection settings, AKA turning Windows Defender on and off because he's been talking too much. Okay, that was lame. So here in Windows, let's go ahead and launch our Windows Security app just by searching for security in the search bar. There it is. And we'll jump right into virus and threat protection. Just under all of our scan options, which we just covered in the previous episode, we have the virus and threat protection settings. Right now, no action needed because we have everything turned on. But let's jump into manage settings and see that happening. Now, the first option I have turned on is probably one of the most powerful tools that Windows Defender will use for us. It's the real-time protection. So check this out. There's this password tool that I was wanting to download. Just launch a browser here. First of all, it's already telling me you shouldn't go there. I'm cool. That's part of the app and browser. I want to download this tool and watch what happens. Bam, immediately. It didn't have to wait for a scan. It's always watching. Windows Defender is diligent. But now in the case where I'm like, I really wanted that. Why did you stop me? You can turn that off. And that's why we have the toggle here. So if I turned it off, it tells you like, hey, it's off. Your device is vulnerable. And it's absolutely true, but I know what I'm doing. Okay, now it allowed it to download. I have the file now. And again, I only did that because I know what this program is. I know where I'm getting it from. Otherwise, you shouldn't do that. But this is a common thing you might do if you are, you know, maybe an ethical hacker and you're trying to do things. You're trying to make a machine vulnerable. That's what you might do. Now, this will turn back on by itself. Windows really wants you to be on with this. Windows Defender never sleeps unless you force him to, and it's just a nap then. He'll wake back up in a moment. But let's turn it back on. Let's make him nervous. Whew, okay. Now this option you really want to have on all the time, and that's cloud delivered protection. What this means is that it's getting all the latest and greatest up-to-date information on what is out there, what is bad. Because like I said before in earlier episodes, hackers are always trying to do things, always trying to create new hacking attempts, new hacking techniques. And it's this service right here that's always staying up to date on the latest and greatest stuff. So when it tries to hit your computer, it already downloaded the information, it already has it in its brain. It keeps Windows Defender smart. That's his intel. That's his, Albert. Is that Batman's butler's name? But look it up. Alfred, not Albert. That's his Alfred. Now you might wonder, how does cloud delivered protection stay up to date? Like, how does it know about all the threats? You're helping it do it with the next option, automatic sample submission, which sounds weird, right? Sometimes, unfortunately, you might get hit with an attack called a zero-day vulnerability. Zero-day. Meaning it has been seen by no one. No one knows how to fix it quite yet. Or it might be even just be a different kind of virus. Maybe we've seen it before, but it's been changed a bit. So Microsoft will automatically submit those bad things as samples to their team, the Alfreds, and they'll figure things out and they'll help everyone else once they had that intel. You could also submit a sample manually if you wanted to. And then one more thing I want to cover, if you scroll down just a bit, we have tamper protection. All these settings you see, we could easily just kind of turn off. Right? Just a little click. And if it's easy for us to turn off, it's probably going to be kind of easy for other apps and possibly malicious actors. Hackers to be able to do that too, but not with tamper protection enabled. Tamper protection prevents other apps that are not you as an admin from changing these security settings. You can always go in here as an admin and change these, but other apps, they can't do it. Only you can put Windows Defender to sleep. Anyways, that is Windows Defender and how he keeps us secure and safe. But he's not done yet. There's a few more things we haven't talked about. I'll see you in the next episode.
Thanks for sticking around. To learn more about Windows and other cool stuff, go to academy.networkchuck.com. Link in the description.